Hello everyone. First of all, thank you for the chance that given to us. Let us introduce our team. Ivan Hatritama, Verania Arneta, Gia Safira Venta, and Miss Perisa Distantina. Now, we would like to present about synthesis of superabsorbent hydrogel based on banana peel cellulose acrylamide carrageenan with microwave grafting method. Introduction. Indonesia is located in a tropical area hit by drought every year. In 2019, Indonesia experienced a long dry season, and this impacted the agricultural sector. One alternative that can be done is the application of polymer technology, namely hydrogel. What is hydrogel? Hydrogel is a cross-linked polymer that can absorb a large amount of water. The hydrogel also have a good biocompatibility. Hydrogel can be synthesized using natural polymer. Natural polymer that can be used to produce a hydrogel is a polysaccharide derivative. And next is the raw material. In 2020, banana peel production in Indonesia reached 8.18 million tons, which means it will create a high banana peel waste. The banana peel used is the type of Musa paradisiaca L. It appears that banana peel contains cellulose, so the banana peel can be used as a raw material for the hydrogel. In addition to banana peel cellulose, this research will also utilize a natural polymer derived from seaweed, namely carrageenan. Carrageenan is a linear sulfate galactan polymer extracted from seaweed or rhodopita. In this research, we use a type of Kappa hicus alvarisi carrageenan, or also known as Kappa carrageenan. And next is the aim of this research. Polysaccharide has lower mechanical properties, so the molecular structure need to be modified by incorporating suitable inorganic or polymeric materials and increasing the crosslink density. In this research, we use the microwave grafting method. This method was chosen because it is an environmentally friendly method with a cleaner approach and better control. In this work, the acrylamide monomer was grafted into banana peel cellulose. Amide group from acrylamide and hydrophilic group from cellulose were linked using microwave energy to produce a cellulose GPEM. The cellulose GPEM was mixed with carrageenan to be a hydrogel. And this is the materials we use in this research. And next, I'm going to explain our research method. Process of preparation banana peel cellulose. The purpose is to take cellulose banana peel only. First, banana peel were washed, cut into small pieces, and dried at a temperature of 70 degrees Celsius until brittle. After that, it was crushed into powder and sieved. And next, it was carried out by the lignification process to get the banana peel cellulose only. And then it was dried at 50 degrees Celsius and crushed into powder. The powder then was called cellulose. And next is the process of microwave grafting synthesis of cellulose GPEM. First, make an acrylamide solution and two variation of cellulose solution. The various ratios of banana peel cellulose and acrylamide are shown in the table. Then, both solution are put into a 1000 ml beaker. The mixture was stirred for 30 minutes at 300 rpm and put in the microwave. When it removed from the microwave, the temperature was kept at less than 70 degrees Celsius and silenced for 24 hours. The reaction was terminated by adding saturated hydroquinone solution and allow the solution to stand for the precipitation process. The solid product was mixed with excess acetone, filtered, and put the residue in the microwave. The dried solid or grafted polymer was crushed into powder size using a mortar. The result of this process was named cellulose grafted polyacrylamide or cellulose GPEM.
Process of preparation PGL. PGL was made by mixing carrageenan and cellulose GPEM powder with a weight ratio variation of 1 to 1 for each variation as shown in the table. The mixture was added into the hot water of 85 degrees Celsius and stirred with a magnetic stirrer until the solution was homogeneous and obtained a 2% solution concentration. The solution was injected into a mixture of calcium chloride solution and potassium chloride solution with a 1 cm layer of palm oil and was done in an ice bath. The PGL form were allowed to stand for 15 minutes while being stirred and then filtered. The PGL were immersed in an ethanol solution for 4 hours. Then the PGL was dried at room temperature until obtained a constant weight. Process of swelling test. Before the immersion process, the dried pichels were waked first and expressed as dry white. Then two grains of similar pichels were immersed in water for 2.5 hours so that the water will diffuse into the pichel. Pichel was waked every 13 minutes to constant wake and expressed as wet white. The equation to calculate the swelling degree is as follows. Result and discussion. Banana peel fullus. After the delignification process and the bleaching process, from 100 g of dried banana peel powder, 2.3 g cellulose powder was produced. Synthesis of cellulose chipem. Polyacrylamide have been grafted attached to the banana peel cellulose. The result of the grafting process will be verified with the FTIR test. The mesgen from cellulose chipem tends to be less than that of banana peel cellulose. This may be caused by the banana peel cellulose was hydrolyzed into its monomers during the microwave grafting. And in the washing process, the monomer dissolved in acetone and didn't precipitate. Cellulose chipem has been synthesized by microwave-initiated method. This method belongs to the polymerization reaction. In general, there are three stages, initiation, propagation, and termination. The polar OH bond responds to microwave radiation and breaks easily, whistle the C-C bond, practically nonpolar, remains unaffected. The cleavage of the OH bond leads to formation of free radical active sets on the backbone of cellulose, from where the graft chains grow. The proposed mechanism of microwave-initiated grafting has been depicted in figure. Hydroquinone reacts with chain radicals to terminate chain propagation, and the resulting hydroquinone radical is stable and doesn't initiate further polymerization. The stability of the hydroquinone radical is due to delocalization of electron charge density throughout the aromatic structure. Thus, addition of hydroquinone quenches the grafting reaction. The process of grafting cellulose chipem is described as follows. Result of FTIR test. The figure show the FTIR spectrum of banana peel cellulose and cellulose chipem with a 2.5 cellulose acrylamide wake ratio. In the FTIR spectrum of banana peel cellulose, the prominent absorption peak of the hydroxyl group was observed at 3,337 cm, which showed the characteristic of cellulose. Cellulose chipem 2.5 didn't show much change from before the grafting process in the FTIR spectrum. It can be observed from the figure as if in the OH stretching vibration peaks from 3,337 cm to 3,344 cm. The peak at 3,284 cm means the stretching vibration of the NH bond from acrylamide. The peak was an indication of the success of grafting acrylamide to the banana peel cellulose backbone. The hydrogel superabsorbent in the form of PGL was synthesized by mixing a cellulose chipem based on banana peel cellulose acrylamide and carrageenan. The table saw that the shape of the PGL after swelling remains spherical. The swollen PGL can return to dry PGL by letting it at room temperature until its wake is constant. So it can be concluded that the PGL is reversible. Comparison of PGL before and after swelling in water for 2.5 hours. The table saw the comparison of the PGL in water stable for a time range of every 13 minutes. The swelling results showed that the PGL with banana peel cellulose damaged within 1 hour. On the other side, cellulose chipem based PGL damaged in about 2.5 hours. The mass ratio of PGL, cellulose, and acrylamide affect water stability in water. The cellulose chipem ratio 1 to 5 shows more extended stability in water than the cellulose chipem 2 to 5. Krebs shows the swelling degree of PGL in the water medium is a function of time. The mass ratio of banana peel cellulose and acrylamide affect the SD value of the PGL. The more mass of banana peel cellulose used, the higher the SD value. The highest swelling degree was obtained for PGL that through a microwave grafting process with ratio wake 2 to 5. The cellulose chipem ratio 1 to 5 shows a lower SD value than without microwave grafting. On the other hand, the cellulose chipem ratio 2 to 5 damage shows a higher SD value.
The next is the conclusion. First, grafting process is successful based on the FTIR result. PGL based on cellulose chipem and PGL based on banana peel cellulose do not show significant SD result. PGL based on cellulose chipem showed more resistant stability in water than PGL based on banana peel cellulose. Swelling degree result of PGL based on cellulose chipem ratio 2 to 5 is higher than cellulose chipem ratio 1 to 5. Swelling degree value was increased with the increase of the mass of banana peel cellulose. PGL based on cellulose chipem ratio 2 to 5 shows more extended stability in water than cellulose chipem ratio 1 to 5. That's all from us. Thank you.